Hey, what's going on, guys? The Horror Man back on Slashback Saturday. This week's Slashback Challenge theme was native slashers. I challenged everyone to watch and review a slasher film native to you. It could have been a slasher filmed or set in your local area. You know, as in native to your land. Or the word native could have taken on a different form of significance in your pick. The movie I watched does in fact feature natives. It's The Dark Power. The Dark Power is a very obscure 1985 slasher film, and it's a total cheese fest. It's about an estate of sacred land, where the chiefs of an ancient Indian tribe buried themselves alive. It was part of a traditional ritual in which they believed they'd return to life. The estate belonged to a man named John Cody, whose native name was Four Eagles. After he passes away in the opening scene, the estate is left to John's nephew, David Cody. The town sheriff, who was close friends with John before John passed, warns David of his uncle's wishes. But of course, because this is a slasher film, David ignores them. A reporter decides to run a story on the land and interviews the sheriff as part of her research. She meets with David as well, and the three learn the truth of the ritualistic burial. Again, David ignores it and rents the house to a group of female college students. In typical 80s slasher fashion, some guys stop by, and it absolutely, of course, has to be the same day the Indian chiefs return. Guess what happens next? You got it. One by one, the co-eds and their friends are picked off by the natives. They are impaled by arrows, slashed by tomahawks, and killed in other gruesome ways. But the key to destroying the dark power may be closer than they realize. Like I said, total cheese fest, from the acting to the dialogue. Almost nothing exciting happens throughout the first half of the film, but then when the good stuff starts, it never lets up. This is another slasher with four killers, and they all look awesome. Each chief has a different look to them, and a weapon of choice. One uses a bow and arrow, another uses a tomahawk, another uses his bare hands to rip his victims apart. He literally rips some guy's hand from his arm before tearing his face off and crushing his skull. This, as you can imagine, is the best and most brutal kill in the film. It's awesome. The movie does feature some scantily clad co-eds and gratuitous nudity. That includes two girls washing up together, one in the bath and one in the shower at the same time. Perverts, stop drooling. The last 20 minutes or so features a lot of yelling between the chief's sort of growling and the victim's screaming. It's sort of obnoxious, but I guess realistically, that's probably how it would go down. There is also a whip duel with a lot of whip sound effects. It's like a lightsaber battle with whips. There's also a cool melting flesh effect that I have to mention. Overall, The Dark Power is worth a watch if you can make it through the slow first half. Believe me, it gets much better and it's worth it in the end. If you like cheesy, supernatural slashers, you'll dig this one. And now it's time for the new Slashback Challenge theme. Well, in a normal year, without COVID, many of us might have been traveling for the holidays. Thanksgiving is right around the corner, but we have to get there first. So this week's Slashback Challenge theme is Traveler's Slashers. I challenge everyone to watch and review a slasher film that features traveling or transportation. The film can feature a plane, a train, a bus, a truck. It can feature someone traveling via motorcycle or bike. And obviously, it can feature a car. But here's the thing. If it's just a car, it must be pertinent to the overall story. So it could be people on a road trip in a car. That would work. If it's a slasher film that features traveling or transportation, it qualifies. So get watching and get reviewing Traveler's Slashers. And be sure to upload your video on Slashback Saturday. I will also be back on Saturday with a new review and reveal of a new theme in the Horror Man's Slash Back Challenge. Thanks for watching, guys. Be kind. Subscribe. Oh, give me a shout.